Hello, everybody, and welcome or welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Repentance Fresh Save File Run. We are going to be going back in with Bethany, which I'm very excited about. I don't know. I liked this character a lot the last time I played her. We have the wild mechanics. If we can get some active items, we can do some really stupid stuff. That's going to be kind of the big shebang we want to work towards. We can press the space bar button right now to just get a little wisp that helps us out. But the real cool stuff comes in. Ooh, 2x damage multiplier, tier multiplier down, shot speed down. Okay. If the little summon does damage based off of our damage, which I think it does, spawns an orbital wisp that shoots spectral tears, can be destroyed. It doesn't say anything about how much damage it do. If it's mine or... What the hell? Are my tears coming out higher right now? Is that a thing? Eh, I don't know. But yeah, I think we can utilize that quite well. Hopefully, if it does scale off of our damage, I think we can do some really stupid stuff. But I don't know. For the sake of non-break, I'd kind of guess it probably can't. So we can actually use active item charges via soul hearts as well with this character. That's something that's kind of weird. You can see the soul hearts underneath our keys. So we can't gain them for like normal use. That's a very important note. Whoop. It's going to make getting deals with the devil and such a little bit trickier. Here we got our fire. Let's charge it up. We just need to make sure we protect it. I think it's not the height of the tier that's a little bit weird. I think it's the fact that it is just really slow. I think that's the thing that's messing me up more than anything. Let's pop into here. The good news about no soul hearts is that I can feel like I can go into sacrifice rooms and curse rooms a lot more, right? That's the nice thing that comes with it, sir. Grants all familiars homing shots. This says familiar, right? Yeah, orbital wisp familiar. That's interesting. That's really interesting indeed. All right, depending on what we get from the boss, we might be able to do some stupid stuff. I mean, we can do some stupid stuff no matter what we... Just went further down than I'd like. At this point, I feel like let's not waste 2 bombs. If that's already going to be a waste of 1... Let's just gamer it up and not take damage and just get the W. Definitely seeing the homing shots from the familiar, so that's really exciting. Honestly, that might be one of the better trinkets we could get. Shot speed up, spawn a card, planetarium chance. 2 of mom's hands come down. Got what here? Full heart. Increased chance for an angel deal. Okay, well, we can't get one on this first floor anyways, as far as I'm aware, so that would be a waste. As far as where the secret room is, we don't have a good lead. I'll just accept this and shmoove on. All right, so I think, does the fire come with us to the next floor? I suppose we could go down here for the extra item chance and then return back to the original path. The risk here being like, definitely going to be less likely that I go hitless until the boss. That's as simple as that. It's just going to be less likely that I don't die on my way there too. Just, I suppose that's a thing too. Whammy. All right, what do we got? Firing occasionally shoots out white creep tier that does double damage and slows enemies. Taking damage shoots a white creep tier. I actually don't think that that's that bad for a one tier item. Host hat, immunity to bombs, and it also shoots some stuff with theoretical homing tiers. Should be kind of nice, I suppose. But yeah, so I guess that's our benefit. We could think of it like, by coming here, we got the host hat instead of the other thing. That's kind of the way to think about it. And in that scenario, is that... was that worth the trade? I'm not sure. Not sure at all. Okay, one fire con. I'll tell you, I don't think I'm going to go for the mines, though. I think that that's... We'll tap out there. We'll go to these two zones and then back through the original path. I think we've done a lot of repentance stuff in a row. And I'm kind of hankering for just a normal chest run, which is something that we do have as a capability. Grab an enemy each. So if there's summons... I thought that would hit me for sure. Kind of hard to tell exactly what's going on. Just go in a circle. Oh my god. There goes that deal. That sucks, man. That sucks. And that's what I was talking about as far as, like, this floor is gonna be trickier. We can't get spirit hearts to protect ourselves. Okay. Whoop. Could go through and... Ooh, there is somebody here. Try and do the mirror stuff on the next floor if I'm feeling crazy. I'm not, though. Okay. The Book of... Whatever the hell it's called again. I think gives us this really, really good chance for a deal with the angel, too, right? Like, obviously, I see we have 100% right now. I think maybe it just guarantees that the first one's a deal with the angel instead of guarantee the first one's a deal with the devil. To then test you in reverse. Just thinking about curse room first. Got a planetarium? The hell, dude? Why do we have a 16% planetarium chance? Did I skip an item room? I thought that was what that was based on. Either we skipped an item room at some point, or it just has a base chance that's higher in the first place. Yes. Please. Alrighty. Wow me. Adds an extra secret room and super secret room. Reveals the secret room each floor. They obtain a beam of light that increases your fire rates. And also gives you half a soul heart, which doesn't actually happen. Okay. So we're definitely going to want to go to our secret rooms. Uh-oh. This room is hell. Okay. I'm happy with that emergency contact usage there. Scoot. All right, stand in the beam of light. We get a stat upgrade. I mean, fantastic. I actually have a good amount of money now, too. Placebo. Gives us a middle ring wisp that spawns a pill when destroyed. Sure. I've done some solid work in checking some pills already, too, so it's kind of nice. So do we get a pill right away and then when one's destroyed, too? I think that might be the case. I can see forever. Actually kind of cracked. Actually, like, incredibly cracked. If there's... Get an extra secret room and super secret room per floor. Okay, that just was showing us where the one we already knew about was. That's an extra secret room and super secret room. Okay, maybe it doesn't come into effect immediately, but... Yeah, the fact that we can kind of just rock... Every one is pretty cool. Outer Ring Wisp with a chance for E. coli tears. No, thank you. Just a damage up. Nothing wrong with that. But speaking of nothing wrong with that, there's nothing wrong with just, let's maybe fight the boss. Shadow Bomb. Okay. Damage is kind of cracked. Run. Angel. Don't get hit. Get an angel. Yes. Blackheart doesn't actually do anything for us. I'm keeping this trinket, dude. Spews a stream of flames, killing an enemy, adds a charge to the urn. Middle Ring Wisp with the chance for blue flame to... I mean, that seems really good. It's a zero charge? Okay, hold on. What? Killing enemies adds a charge to the urn. How do I know how many charges it has? This thing is nuts. The annoying thing is that the placebo pill is probably smarter. And I... Like, the placebo plus I can see forever, considering... The fact that we get the Giga stuff. The Flame Tear is good. Considering we get the tears up every single time we find a secret room, the ability to find every single secret room and open it and super secret room for completely free seems like a no-brainer. Am I wrong? God, this is a weird one. Ah, God. It's a weird one. I don't feel great about skipping that. We should probably get that secret room. Or the... Okay, do we have any hearts around? We got a couple. Gonna pop that. Just hoping for hearts. Tears down. Just gonna face check it. It only takes one bomb for us to get this. It feels like it's more. Okay, one bomb right here would have done. Okay. At this point, in for a penny, in for pounds. I'm not going to teleport out, even though I can. Okay, so we'll go to the next floor, where I think we are going to really see the benefit of the placebo I can see forever combo. We're definitely not doing no boss rush stuff with all this teleporting we've got. I'm going to take damage, don't you worry. Alright. Down we go. We'll use the I Can See Forever placebo immediately. Okay. I mean, I guess the fact that we know where they are already... Yeah, probably it probably doesn't check out. But the fact that we'll never miss one ever... Whoa. It's a pretty big deal. Okay. Infested. What makes you larger? Bombs are key. I guess that's fine. Got two of these. Range down. Health up. Range up. Okay. Alright. Yeah, I just want the ability to know what those are. I feel like it's gonna, you know... be very, very helpful for us. Whoop. Could hop in there, but... I mean, like, just look at this. We lose a fire there, but... Like, I just can't be mad. We have the three keys. I can't believe he didn't take fire item that is obviously top tier in Isaac. I don't know, dude. I mean, we want to get in there for the stat upgrade regardless. All right, so what does it do? Inner Ring Wisp that has a 3.5% chance for Fear Tears that does the Necronomicon effect when destroyed is pretty good, too. There's so many really good ones. Can't wait for the one room that completely destroys everything I have. But right now, all of the, like, ooh, the homing. It's nice because we can aim with our tears. And the homing's just going to help us out. Why does the paralysis pill have a 6 charge? The hell is up with that, dude? That's wacky. All right. Good payout, so I'll do another one. Is that good? Yeah, it's good. Yeah, I mean, it's all worth it. Oh, this is... this sucks. Not because it's a difficult room, but because we're gonna just lose a lot of fires. There's not much I can do about it. That sucks. Most annoying room for us, and it's not even an actual room, really. Tears up is pretty good. Alright. We still have our chance here. Go, 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 go. God, our damage! It's just nuts. This is a very good item for us right now. Health, yep, I'll take it. Light, I'll certainly take it as well. Get in my face. Get out of my face! Stompy. I could get it for that, but yeah, don't care about soul hearts that much. There's technically no downside. It just feels weird. We could have placeboed it to get the stompy effect, I guess, but like, just it feels strange. I'm popping the I Can See Forever pill. I mean, if you haven't figured it out, I'm popping it because I want the extra fires. Let me check something. Okay, so the item reveals one random pickup. Or one random secret room. Let's do that and call it. I think that's just good enough. So I'll keep the I Can See Forever because it does indeed... Oh, okay, so the health up pill has like a crazy charge, by the way, anyways. So there's that. God, I'm just a monster. I'm a freaking monster. But yeah, I don't know. It's going to be a lot of tears up. It's just a hard thing to figure out what the right call is. Because I don't want to miss any of those secret rooms. I'm obviously not going to do that. But, like, I mean, look at this. Things can't be too bad. Touching enemies petrifies them. Poop spawned by Isaac has a high chance to be golden poop. That's a fun little thing I didn't know about. Oh, this is... overestimating my size a little bit there. I picked this up, right? There's no reason to not use it just once there. Battery pack. It's a little bit funky. It's not actually that beneficial. Probably one of the less good battery items for us right now. I think we leave. Go. Oh, absolutely. We I'm not sacrificing one of the best things we have going for us, which is our giga health. We take dead cat all the time. Why does my tier rate still feel so bad? Like, I know mascara destroys the multiplier. But I could have sworn it was higher just a moment ago. Probably wasn't. Weep. Infested. PhD would be so good today. Just double checking if there was a secret room back here. Okay, so all of them's gonna be revealed. Another health up. I mean, I guess we just get up to max, I suppose, right? Why wouldn't we? Like, I'll take it and I'll just rock this for the floor. Why wouldn't I suppose, right? Now that we've got the reveal. Tears up. Is it only for the floor? Is that why? Oh, that sucks if so. That's much less good. But also not terrible, because it's still strong. But boy, that is obviously a lot less effective. We'll want to go for all the secret rooms first. Takes it from an item that I was like, yeah, getting that early is incredible, to an item where I'm like, okay. It's pretty good. It's a pretty noticeable difference. Well. Go. But that makes everything make more sense.
Make it make sense!
Steps one. We fight. Should have tried to grab the last tears up. I mean, it's not like we have that high of an angel chance anyways here. We get it. Not gonna make that much of a difference. Goes from probably not happening to, I guess it could happen. Yeah. Range up. Don't mind if I do. But yeah, I guess we tunnel vision all the secret rooms is the plan. We placebo, well, I mean, I guess if we want to tunnel vision all the secret rooms, then we gotta, I don't know. It's a neat, I'll admit, regardless, it's a neat kind of gimmick that we've got going on here today. Like the secret room hunter gimmick. It's kind of fun. It's an eternal heart out there. It's even one fewer. What the hell? Luck up pill. That could be fun. If I find like a tears up, obviously I'm gonna go for that instead. But that's gotta be like a, what, like a 12 room charge, something crazy like that. Is this worth a bomb? It is when it's a chest, I think. Speed up. I don't really need to get a million of those. Sure. What's our range at? It's not bad. All things considered, it's still kind of chunking. Which is not necessarily what you want to hear with your number one. Clear out the rooms first. So yeah, the range and everything, it's obviously like a slight concern, but we got our huge range up from somewhere. I don't know if it's the mascara has it built in, or if it was just like, we just happened to get a hell of a lot. I mean, I can't be mad. I can't be mad at that. But we definitely don't need the health up pill anymore. We also could have just eaten the last one. So now we're looking for yet another pill. Because the thing is, whenever we eat the pill and everything, like, I don't know. We are getting more pills than normal from this whole shebang. Due to the fact that when the things explode, they also give us a pill. You know? We grab the eye can see forever. If nothing else, we'll just rock back with that. Would I take a luck pill? Ooh, that's one of the only things that would... That's one of the only... things that would maybe... It's not as noticeable as I would have thought. Okay, it's definitely... It's pretty good. I think we take it. Because our fires ain't gonna last forever. I need spectral tears to go with this flight. Oh, I didn't even see that one. Well, there goes my angel chance, because I just realized, yeah, I have not done the boss, have I? Oh, I did a long... I did ages ago, man. Ages ago. There's our last super secret. We have enough health. I can do it. Okay, speed up. There's the luck up. Range down. Unidentified. This is just in case, you know? Do I need more than this? Speed. Do I have any luck effects? None of my tiers have any luck-based effects. Yeah, I guess I don't really care that much. I'll, do that. That. Luck up. Yeah, I think that's fine. I think that's just good enough. This would be a great room for a sacrifice, or great floor for a sacrifice room. I mean, I'm willing to just take a billion, but like, what's the correct payout there? I mean, we could get the health, like, who cares? Does the Eternal Heart give you health? Go up to 500, please. 5500, please. Okay. All right. Got our pill. I'm going to go with this. I mean, I'll take the Eternal Heart since we don't care even slightly about boss rush. Just in case it gives you a heal on your way out. God, this really could beat Mother. Oh, well. We don't have the stuff to fight after. We could do this. He says, I want to do a regular run for regular people. Okay. Definite temptation on this one. Good news is we don't have the I Can See Forever pill yet, but we do just have the room visible anyways. Ba-bomb. Bomb, ba-bomb, bomb. Coat hanger. Yeah, boy. Uh-oh. Bombs are key. You kind of just, like, Keys are something you just want enough. Oh, God, this is annoying. That is exceptionally annoying. Keys are something you just kind of want enough of. Bombs are something you can... Just get rid of that. Oh, shoot. I forgot to explain a mod I have. Ah, oh, that's one way to spoil it. It's an emote mod. Does it... Oh, I don't have it at the... There. I gotta be careful not to go through all of them because they're set to their defaults. It'll be relevant later. You'll see. That's all I'll talk about with that right now. There goes that. I turn them into gold. Okay. The golden poop. All right. Double check a room that we've already been, just in case. I don't think it can be in there. But yeah, I wouldn't mind playing the Devil Beggar. Oh, God. Whoop. They're both range up pills. I feel like my range is fine, though. If I take two of them, it's just going to be good enough. Better than having to come back. I don't know if I fly over the pit if they can't get to me. I'd assume they can't, but I'm all good. The thing is, the kind of funny thing, if I take the I found pills or whatever, the one charge placebo item, I could just generate lots of pills. Luck up highlights location of secret rooms. I mean, I know from past experience that I'm not actually going to see that. All right, let's do a hard... Let's do a difficult path now. You give me Psyfly. We gotta do it now, right? Yeah, you gotta. Tears down, no thank you. So is this... Yeah, this is depths 2. Now let's start looking for... we're gonna have to sacrifice our secret stuff, but I think that's just okay. Well, I guess I'll take it. Just to protect me from stuff, I suppose. Okay. I think that it takes a hit. Range up. Oh, there's the skull, by the way. Greed! Love Psyfly. There's one issue with Psyfly, and it's a suffering from success one. And it's Psyfly's so good at blocking bullets for you that the moment you kind of like get used to it is when you'll take damage. But I guess we don't have to take this to the next floor, per se. Another lucky penny. I'm thinking that, does luck give you more lucky pennies? Is it luck begets luck begets luck? I wish I had a luck-based item. I mean, our fire rate is, it's just silly. So placebo can't copy our card. That would be silly. But yeah, we gotta go in with the fool card for reasons. That damage is just so good. I'm legally obliged. Whoop. Just take the Polaroid, and we put it right there, or the negative. So I do think we lose it, unfortunately, but... So it's completely irrelevant. Bombs are key. I'll take this one with us, I suppose, right? Like, it's not a big deal. The shop was greed. Oh, shoot. Which one was the starting room? Oh, God. Which one was it? Right here? No. Here? No. Here for sure. Okay, it actually is. All right. Down we's go. I don't really remember. I remember the end of this. Gehenna 2. All right. Use that I can see forever just in case. So it is a normal floor right now. The fool. I want to save myself a heart. Which I kind of... I feel like I suppose I could. Well, okay. Fine. Another range uphill. Bombs are key. One makes you larger. At this point, sure. Now we break rocks for better or worse. I'm so freaking large. Range up. I mean, I should have more than enough. Oh, God. The funny thing is, my hitbox is the same. So as large as I am, I'm not really. Wait, what? Where am I supposed to... What? Is one of these actually, like, a real guy? I didn't hit the button. I could have sworn I did, because my character was on it. All right, what's the placebo charge for pheromones? 2. I think that there's a... I think there's play in that. Start using it to actually charge up some of these familiars, get more pills that way. Maybe we find an even better pill that we don't have already. Ooh, Nelly. Don't know what these guys do. These guys, you can only assume it's brimstone. Where am I? So yeah, we break all of the rocks. Which is not necessarily good. But it is funny. We could look for a crawl space, I guess. Okay, but there's also the bomb. That's the downside of Stompy right there. Okay. Okay. That ain't too shabby. You know, that's worth it. Okay, that's kind of nuts. That turns pheromone pill into something kind of goated. Oh, hello, I said. All right, I don't even know necessarily if this is a boss, if I remember correctly. There's something else, but... Let's get ourselves charged up with finding that other super secret room and stuff, just in case. Another health up. I'm good, thanks. Whoa. Another one makes you larger. I think I'm fine, thanks. Boiled baby. Odd mushroom? Sure? I'm kind of looking for the one more secret room. Also, it's funny that I, in a weird roundabout... Jesus. I can't see. In a weird roundabout way. Oh, my lord. Increased angel chance. I don't think there is one. We gotta stop, though, because we might have something coming up right now. As much as I want to, I don't know. Maybe I'll see, like, a whole bunch of health drops. Shop could be an interesting place for that, too. Oh. Super greed. I mean, there's not really anything to do with all this money, but thank you. Okay, so we have a half of a heart down here. Teleports to the devil room if it's... Okay. Tears up. Eternal Heart allows angel rooms to spawn after taking a devil deal. Taking red heart damage does not reduce. Thank you for the little boost to the tears up, I suppose. Man. Filthy. Truly filthy, and we're immediately rewarded. Gorp? We have 8 soul hearts, so we could even pheromones early. Begin the ascent. Trinkets left in previous treasure or boss rooms turn into cracked keys. Oh, I doubt that I did that. It also was not my plan to do anything with this. I highly doubt.
It's gone. Just get over it.
You mean it's gone.
All right. Here I am, traversing and reversing. Whoop. Do not touch the bomb. Got. So do I have to do the full run again? Surely not. God, I hope I left a trinket in one of those rooms on accident. Okay. We want to check all the item rooms just in case. I might have. I don't freaking recall. I don't remember this. At all. I don't know what you're talking about, because I definitely was not here. Mm-hmm. Alright, we checked. Okay, now that we've got all of these, the pheromone pills generating the extra fires instead... Now the homing probably would have been a better angle. Okay. Yeah, just boss room, item room. Yo, what? What are you talking about? There's a trinket in the... Okay. Methinks it's something I couldn't have done yet. Brutal. Oops, shouldn't be doing the pheromones outside of the room, but... Okay. What floor are we on? Depth 1. We'll get there. We gotta basically do one room without pheromones, one room with pheromones, unless we want to start using up our soul hearts. Which would probably be better to save, like, for a final fight type thing. Death card. I can see forever. I mean, surely I have all the range I need. one would imagine. Can there even be secret rooms in the ascent? I don't know. Two of diamonds. Double your coins. Sure. Don't mind if I do. I don't even need to check the item rooms, I guess, at this point, since I don't think that we have the cracked key unlock thing as of right now. Well, there goes most of my tears. Do I have screen-wide tears with number one? I do. Double checking for the sake of it. Making sure. Ooh, boy. Ooh, boy. My freaking head! It's so far in the way. And I could spend my charges. I think I spend my charges. The remaining charges there just to speed this bad boy up. The bad boy up. Pick it up. Yeah, I found pills. It's an interesting idea instead, since it has a one-room charge. That's just a quick way to get lots of fires, basically. Which is not a bad idea. We could basically convert every single soul heart into a fire. The shame is that we can't, you know, farm secret room stuff for the fire rate. And I'm, you know what? I'm really noticing. I do think, in hindsight, it was not a bad call. Yeah, there's another trinket.
Pray for your salvation. Come, pray with us.
Oh, here we go. Give me some. No breakfast. Do I care? Do I care to play this? It can give us flies, right? What do I want? Oh my god, 100 coins. Great. Okay. Woo! Man. Placebo pheromones, I tell you. It's the secret goated. Is there an enemy behind my big head? I can't tell. All right, we're almost done. Zoop. Downpour one. We're very close. Sir? I mean, I don't really want breakfast. Or lunch. Double your number of bombs, I suppose. Does that remove it from the pool or something at least? I don't know. Change up. I'm not going to do another spacebar version of that because it'll make it take forever for us to get the pheromones charged back up and running. Double your number of bombs, but again, sure. I feel like there might be a max cap of these fires. That or we're just continually killing them on accident here. Go. Okay. Gotta be a basement floor one here soon. Alright, yeah, we I just you know, I keep on checking. Basement one. Yeah, I keep on... Oof. Okay, please be my friend. Thank you. He's so quiet. Nothing there. Oh, God. Oh, God. Please, Sci-Fly. Protect my fires. Can I get a size down pill? I feel like they're the whole thing where there has to be a good pill and a bad pill of every type. At this point, I think it has to be false. Otherwise, what the hell, dude? We've seen so many tiers down and no tiers up to go with it. I'm thinking that that's just wrong. Ooh. This is an interesting it's an interesting ending. I like the gimmick of it. I do have the same feeling I had about it the first time where I'm like, it's kind of long. Oop, filled with goodies. When we get hit, we might drop something. That's actually legit. Okay. Go, go, go. It's gotta be it. Yes. All right. Up we go. Bum, 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 bum. All righty. Okay. Honestly? Let's sit down and watch some telly. This is where we have that one thing, right? We got a... The red keys appear in the basement. Create a red room adjacent to a regular room. I think we want to take it and... Yes, and do it right there. What's the red key tier do? Chance to create red doors when entering a new room. Oh, okay. We don't need to do that again. We've unlocked a new character. Tainted Bethany. We don't even need to win. Oh, that's right. We gotta sleep in the bed. We don't even need the wind to do that, which I did forget, which is kind of a nice thing. So the red key, you get the red key the first time. That's how that works. Oh, God. And every time after that, I'm just so big. It's my biggest concern of this run is that my character is just too large. I'm not going to be able to dodge some of this stuff. Best music in the game incoming. Okay, all my pills just got destroyed. I think we gotta kill the TV. Sci-Fly is an absolute god. Ooh. All right, phase one done, son. Oh. Huh? Oh God, it goes three times. Four times. Thank you, Sci-Fly. Can I charm him? Shoot. Whoop. God, what a cool boss. Just focusing up. since I gotta pay attention to where I am, like, five times more than normal. Alright. No, that wasn't the final boss of this path. This is the final boss of this path. And by that I mean, this is one of the parts of the final boss of this path. Okay. Sci-Fly's... I probably would not have gone for this path if it weren't for Sci-Fly here. Like I said. The moment I got that, I'm like, I'm throwing a much more difficult unlock away if I don't go for this. Holy! Okay. Won't let me fire off another bomb. Oh, it is. It's just below me. Why is it sometimes I can shoot it behind me? That range up is kind of doing some work here, isn't it? Oh! Okay, don't really know what I'm supposed to do here. So I'll just say okay, and run in a circle. Same thing I do at social gatherings. Something hit me twice, and I don't know what it is. It was a fly. Hello. I'm gonna die here. Please perish. I want a bomb so bad, but it's also like... Fires? I'm hurting. I'm freaking hurting. This fight needs to stop, man. I didn't know if those could possibly be pheromoned. They can. He can. It's even more surprising. This is tough to sight read. Over and over and over. Huh. At the same time, huh? Oh, come on, dude. What? Was that one? That final hit. Oh, this is what I remember. We can bomb here. Okay. The Stompy, Ooh. There go my fires. Any fires I had. Whoa, okay. Rude. Oh, rude again. You come on. Stompy should make it so you're immune to that happening. Oh, what is this attack? I'm dead. Am I? I'm fine. Incoming finale part of that attack? Yep, of course. Come on! I'm dead. Holy crap!
Then suddenly, the sky above cracked open, and a white beam of light reached down into the earth, smiting the mother of harlots asunder, and setting the blood lake to a boil. As the beast descended down into the lake of fire, Isaac ascended towards the crack in the sky, and as he flew, he could see echoes of his past before him. He saw his mother mourning the loss of her son. He saw his father leaving them without turning to say goodbye. He saw his mother sleeping and his father taking money from her purse. He heard the late night fights they had that kept him up at night, and the guilt he felt for what he believed he was causing. He felt the pain in his stomach during those sleepless nights, and saw his shadow in the closet waiting for him. As he rose, he felt his fears drop from his body, his shame, his worry, pulled from his being. As he became lighter, his ascent became faster. He saw his one true companion alive and well. He saw his mother and father together again, holding each other. He felt his mother kissing him on the head after he had said his prayers, and the comfort in knowing someone was watching over him. He saw his own birth, and the faces of his parents filled with joy and optimism. And then he saw nothing.
Are you sure this is how you want this story to end, Isaac? You're the one writing it. It doesn't have to end this way. Here, how about we tell it a different way? Maybe a happy ending?
Okay, Daddy.
Good. Are you getting sleepy yet?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Isaac and his parents lived in a small house on the top of a hill.
And there you go. For those of you who, after all this time, thought that, oh, this game's got so, it's so messed up. I mean, it is. It is. But also, it's got a sweet ending. I think that that's kind of the canonical ending there. But also, this music freaks me the hell out. So I'm going to go ahead and say thank you for that. Jar of Wisps has appeared in the basement. We've done that. I don't think that's the final, like, picture there, but oh my lord. So, if you thought there was a lot of content in Isaac already, let me introduce you to the fact that there's twice as many characters as you thought. We have tainted versions of every single character that play 100% different than all the other characters on the other side, and have unlocks for all of the bosses that the other characters have. Except there might be a couple that they don't, I guess. I can't remember. But there's unlocks out the wazoo for every one of these characters as well. Gotta unlock them the same way we did with Bethany, except the key will not be in that chest. We have to do another little sneaky thing that was kind of alluded to in this episode here already. But alas, did not think that was going to happen. That is that, and that's going to do it here for today. We got to stop having butt clench finishes. It's just too much. But also, the beast needs to not have so many absolute BS, like, spawn on top of you attacks across his multiple phases. That's my personal opinion. There's some malarkey. I'm sure it's like, just know not to be there, but whatever. We'll get used to it. We'll learn it. Wild fight. I love Dogma. I think the Dogma fight is, like, one of the best fights in the game. truthfully, I think it's probably one of my favorite fights in the game. Favorite soundtrack, favorite look. I love Dogma so much. I wish that my big head wasn't covering it. But alas, alas, that is that. That's going to do it here for today. We'll probably do a cooldown challenge, or maybe we'll actually, for real, do a normal run today. Tomorrow, rather. We'll see. Thank you for watching, though. Check out the channel. Rogue likes it more every single day. If you'd be sad to see this series go, you gotta let me know in the form of a comment down below. Thank you for watching. Check out the channel for Rogue likes it more every single day, and I'll see you next time. Bye!